Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you how you can build a very simple and rather compact 5 block wide and infinitely expandable block swapper in the floor. And that is this thing here. This is a more or less collab between me and Mr. Jopili, who came up with a very compact and simple module design, and I provided a rather compact control circuit with the entire thing to work with. And well, that's the final product here. So let's quickly show this in action. So as you can see, I have this 5 wide strip of blocks here, but once I flick the lever, those blocks get swapped out, and in this case I even have a little message here. So with 5 blocks wide, you can actually start putting down some letters and messages. Of course, you can also use this just to beautify your base. So anyway, it also looks, of course, in the opposite direction, as you can see here. And that's the general idea behind this. Now let's talk about the size of it. It's in total 29 blocks wide, 6 blocks high, and the length is 2 blocks for the control circuit and 1 block for each of those modules. So the modules are only 1 block wide and infinitely tileable without problems. Or as wide tileable as the loaded chunks go for that case. Now for the resources you will need for the control circuit: some building blocks, then 27 redstone dust, 2 redstone torches, 26 repeaters, 5 observers, 2 pistons, and for example a lever as an input. Then for each module you will need the blocks to swap out, then about half a stack of normal blocks, 10 redstone dust, redstone repeaters, 36 observers, 8 lamps, 4 pistons, and 11 sticky pistons. So as you can see, it has a bit of need for some special resources, but in total it's actually quite cheap for what it does. But anyway, that's essentially all you're gonna need to know. So let's quickly show you how to build this block swapper here. Okay, so I would recommend building one module before you build the actual control circuit, so you know where everything goes. And that here is one of those modules here. Again, kudos to Mr. Jopili for coming up with this very compact and rather simple design here. So now let's show you how to build this module. Essentially, you start with those 5 blocks here, which are in the end position. Those will be swapped out with those 5 blocks on this side here. Then from those 5 blocks you go down 4 blocks and place your first observer of the observer chain, of the observer chains that chain together the various modules. Then from there on go upwards, and then a simple sticky piston on top, and that's the center of the entire thing. Then both sides are completely symmetrical. The only difference in this case is that you have 5 blocks here, and on this side the 5 blocks are already in the end position. So now for this side, you go to this edge here, then 1 down and 2 to this side. Then you place 9 blocks in a 6 again pattern, so you get 5 lowered and 4 raised blocks. Then on the lower blocks you place one repeater on 4 ticks, then 2 on 2 ticks, and 2 on 3 ticks. Then put redstone lamps on top of the raised blocks. Next, let's go to the back here. Again, we have our hopper chain, which observer chain, which chains together the modules. Then one observer observing this chain and feeding directly into the repeaters, then 2 observers upwards, and then this 6-second pattern of observers going upwards like that. Next, put in blocks inside of those gaps here and at the back here, and finally 3 sticky pistons and 2 normal pistons, and then on this side 5 normal blocks, and on the opposite side you would place the blocks right on top of the center. Okay. So once you've built the first module, it's time to build the control circuit. For this, start with a normal piston right besides one of those repeaters here. then normal blocks in front of those observers here. Now those blocks at the top should be retracted. Next, let's put the block here, then a temporary block raised like that. Put the observer facing downwards like so, then place this block with some redstone. Then go down here and place a row of 9 blocks with repeaters on them. Put them all on 4 ticks except for the last one, which is on 2 ticks. Like so. Then, oops, block right in front of it, and next to that, normal piston again, and 3 blocks in between here. Next, block diagonally like so. Redstone torch towards the module. Then 4 blocks in a T-shape like that. Put down a repeater on 1 tick, 2 on 4 ticks, and 1 on 3 ticks. Then blocks in front of the repeaters. Diagonally observer facing downwards with redstone on top. Then 4 normal blocks and another observer facing downwards like that. Then a repeater on 3 ticks and 4 on 4 ticks. Next, let's put a block below this observer here, and then a chain of blocks going below this block here, and then going around the corner until we reach this place here. And then finally put some redstone dust down like that. Now this module here will activate. It needs 3 more ticks to be in the right condition again, so let's remove this one. So this is 2. Then let's quickly place and remove again. And then finally last. And now you should have this configuration. Of course, alternatively, you can wait until the blocks here are in the middle and then put the pistons here manually in this configuration. So now to this side. First, let's place a row of 8 blocks down on top of the repeaters here. Then a raised block at the end with a torch on the side. Then 4 more blocks here, followed by 3 repeaters on 4 ticks, and a line of redstone running into this block here. Now the torch should turn off. Then diving into the torch, put another observer, followed by 4 normal blocks and 1 observer. Redstone on top of this one here, and again 3 tick repeater and 4 4 tick repeaters. And now similar to before, 1 block below this one here, then a row of blocks until we are below this observer, and then we go around the corner until we are right in front of the observer there. And again we put some redstone dust down, and we'll need to put again in total 4 pulses for this module. Okay, and that should be actually all. So now all you have to do is put a lever, for example, on this block here. If you want to power this redstone line here, I would recommend putting some redstone on top of here, so this block gets also powered every time. And now let's see. Okay, this seems to work at least. Okay, this looks good so far. And now, final test. And as you can see, the entire thing now works. And the last step then is, of course, copying this module here over and over until you reach the length you actually want. And in the end, you should have something similar to this here. And with that, the last part then would be filling in the actual floor to hide everything of the actual mechanics. But that was essentially how you can build this 5-wide floor block swapper. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!